We want to determine the exact trig function values using reference triangles. So we want to find all six trig function values for negative 150 degrees. So the first step is to sketch the angle in standard position. Because the angle is negative, we'll rotate clockwise from the positive x-axis. So here's the initial side of the angle. And now we'll rotate clockwise 150 degrees. Well, 1/4 rotation clockwise to here would be negative 90 degrees, which means you need to rotate another 60 degrees clockwise from here. So we would rotate to somewhere in here. So this would be the terminal side of negative 150 degrees, which means our reference angle, or the angle between the x-axis and the terminal side, would be 30 degrees. To form the reference triangle, we'll sketch a perpendicular segment from the terminal side to the x-axis. So this black triangle is our reference triangle. And because we have a 30, 60, 90 right triangle, we should recognize that we can label the short leg 1, the hypotenuse 2, and the longer leg square root 3. But now it's important that we check the sign of the legs based upon the quadrant that we're in. Because we're in quadrant 3, where the x coordinate is negative and the y coordinate is negative, both legs need to be negative. And now we can use this reference angle of 30 degrees and this reference triangle to determine all six trig function values. This video does assume that you're familiar with determining all of the six trig function values from a right triangle. If not, you may want to pause the video here and review these notes. So the sine of negative 150 degrees will be the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse, which in this case would be negative 1 divided by 2, or negative 1/2. The cosine function value would be the ratio of the adjacent side to the hypotenuse, or negative square root 3 divided by 2. Next, we have the secant function value of negative 150 degrees. Remember, the secant function is equal to the reciprocal of the cosine function. So if cosine is equal to negative square root 3 over 2, that means the secant value would be negative 2 over square root 3. Or using the reference triangle, it would be the ratio of the hypotenuse to the adjacent side. Again, 2 divided by negative square root 3, or this fraction here. But notice how the denominator is irrational. And sometimes we are asked to rationalize a denominator. So let's go ahead and show how we would do that. If we have negative 2 over square root 3, to rationalize this, we would multiply by the square root of 3 over the square root of 3. So we would have negative 2 square root 3 divided by 3. So we can also express the value in this form with a rational denominator. So it really depends on your instructor. And then for the cosecant of negative 150 degrees, cosecant is equal to the reciprocal of sine. So if the sine function value is negative 1/2, the cosecant function value would have to be negative 2 over 1, or just negative 2. Or using the reference triangle, it would be the ratio of the hypotenuse to the opposite side, or 2 divided by negative 1. The tangent of negative 150 degrees would be equal to the ratio of the opposite side to the adjacent side, or negative 1 divided by negative square root 3. A negative divided by a negative is positive, so this would be 1 divided by square root 3. But again, we may be asked to rationalize the denominator. So let's go ahead and show that. If we have 1 divided by square root 3, to rationalize this, we would multiply by the square root of 3 over the square root of 3, which is simplified to the square root of 3 divided by 3. So you may be asked to express the value in this form as well with a rational denominator. And then since cotangent is equal to the reciprocal of tangent, if the cotangent function value was 1 over square root 3, then the cotangent value would be square root 3 over 1, or just square root 3. Or again, using the reference triangle, we would have the ratio of the adjacent side to the opposite side, which would be negative square root 3 divided by negative 1, which would still give us square root 3. That'll do it for this example.